Okay, so twice in the same week, I have gotten the same question. So I guess it's time to answer it for all of you. I've been asked, what books do I recommend that someone goes to read to learn more and develop their professional learning around mathematics? I'm Christina Tonneville, the recovering traditionalist, and I hope you'll stick around for the next few minutes as I talk about books that I highly recommend in our quest to build our math minds so we can build the math minds of our students. Now, as I was thinking about how I wanted to do this video, I was thinking, like, should I talk about the older books that have had such a profound impact on my teaching and my understanding of how kids learn math? Or should I go with some new books that are out that have fresh ideas and great ideas as well? But then I really started to think about it. It's not about what I need and what I want. It's about what you need. Or if you are a math specialist or a math coach at your district and you're trying to plan a book study for this next semester when you come back from the holiday break for the teachers you work with, it's not about what you want them to learn. It's about what they need to learn, what they want to learn, right? If they are excited about learning about it, if you're excited about learning about it, then you're going to love it. It's not what I love. It's what you are wanting and needing right now. So it is the holiday break right now. This is going to be a short video because, as you can see, I have so many I could recommend, and I'm not going to sit here and show you every single one of them. Instead, I'm going to encourage you to get the download right below this video. And I've broken it into two categories. Now, again, this is totally not an exhaustive list of what potentially you could read. It's some of my favorites from this bookshelf back here that I think are great, but I've divided them into two categories. The first category is more theory and like best practices of teaching mathematics. And then the other one is more practical application. Now, a lot of times they are very intermixed. There might be a book that is really theory-based, but intersperses things that are practical ideas that you can be using. But then there's others that it's more focused on giving you practical things to try out in your classroom with the theory intermixed. So it's not a great divide, and some of them fit into both categories, but I tried to give you ones that I felt like it's more theory-based and you can have discussions about what you're going to be trying versus ones that are theory-based but have a lot more of the, okay, here's an activity, try this, here's ways that you can implement it in your classroom kind of books. So that's what they're divided into. I hope that you will find some wonderful books to be able to build your math mind as you're working to build the math minds of your students. Happy holidays and enjoy your break.